wouldn't want to do that. Sometimes it seems like the ball has a mind of its own. Once you let it go, you never know what's going to happen. But one thing's for sure, bowling balls are made to take a pounding. And here's how they're made. This is the Ebonite Bowling Ball Factory in Hopkinsville, Kentucky. More balls are made here than anywhere else in the world. A bowling ball has two parts, a tough outer shell and a heavy center or core. The core gives the ball its weight. The core is made first. Workers clip plastic molds together and send them one by one down the line. A gooey plastic cement pours into each of the molds. Fill her up. Once the molds are dry, they're cracked open like giant eggs, and the cores pop right out. The cores are round, except for an extra knob on the end. The denobber machine solves that problem. Take a trip through the factory. Looks like a giant pinball machine, doesn't it? Then the cores are weighed on a digital scale and sorted into bins. The next step is to make the outer shells. Each core is put into the center of a larger mold. A liquid plastic called polyester is added to the mold. It's the same polyester clothing is made from, only in a different form. Polyester comes in lots of bright colors, so bowling balls can be stylish. After the plastic hardens, each ball goes to the grinder. This machine smooths the surface and gives the ball a bath. Every ball is rubbed and buffed to a perfect shine. Time to test for bumps or cracks. Bowling balls have to be perfectly round to glide down the lane for a strike. A special machine stamps each ball with the company name. When you add a dash of color, it really stands out. These balls are sanded down for a rough surface. That's for bowlers who like a ball that really curves. Other balls are left slick and shiny, so they'll roll straight down the lane. not until a last spray of polish for the perfect shine. At last, the balls are ready to roll. They're shipped to bowling centers and stores, where finger holes will be drilled and each ball custom fit just for you. I love watching the balls smash into the pins. Sometimes they explode. And sometimes they barely topple over. But if you hit them just right, they look like they're dancing.